Hello, I'm John Ombler, the Acting Chief Executive of the Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Authority. One of the really interesting things about the rebuild of a city is looking at all of the blank spaces that end up on walls around the city as buildings are being demolished and spaces are made available. And as you walk around the city now, you'll see lots of street art. This is part of the Spectrum Street Art Festival, which is underway in the city at the moment. There's some fantastic things to look at as you walk around, and also at the YMCA, where the artworks of a number of these people are displayed, together with the works of Banksy, that renowned street artist from the UK. On the screen, you'll see a photograph of one of the really special bits of street art as you go down Manchester Street towards the South Frame. This is a magnificent piece and one of my favourites. It's at the Innovation Precinct end of the South Frame, and of course the South Frame extends across the south, as you'd expect, to the Health Precinct at the other end. We expect that this precinct will have lots of small businesses, lots of activity, and of course it borders the Central Business District. As you will be aware by now, we are seeking feedback on the six shortlisted proposals for the earthquake memorial. You'll see these on the screen now. This, while not the largest of the anchor projects by any means, is arguably one of the most important, if not the most important. It's important as a place of remembrance for the families of those who died, for those who were injured, for those who were affected in many ways, including those who came to help as part of the recovery from the earthquake. We want this to be a lasting memorial, and we're working very closely with both the Christchurch City Council and Ngāi Tahu on this project. If you want to give feedback, the address for giving that is on your screen. We're currently calling for input from the public, from you, about the future of Victoria Square. This is an important part of the Avon River precinct, and there's a number of elements to the square which we'd really like to see fixed up for the future. Things like the Bowker Fountain, which isn't even a shadow of its former self. Things like improving the lighting in the square and making it the square that Cantabrians need for the future, that they want for the future. We're working closely with both the Christchurch City Council and Ngāi Tahu, for whom this is a very special place, as we plan the future for Victoria Square. So please have your input and give us your thoughts about what would make this the Victoria Square that you want for the future. Lastly today, I'd like to draw your attention to a really smart smartphone app that we've developed called Christchurch Story, and it's geotagged so that as you walk around the city, you can get up-to-date stories about things that are happening near where you are. It's not just stories about bricks and mortar. It's stories about people like you and others, people that are involved in the recovery and the exciting things they're doing. You can download this app from the App Store or from Google Play just by searching Christchurch Story. For more information about these topics and lots of other interesting stuff, you can look at the future Christchurch update, which will be in your mailbox this weekend. And of course, you can go to the CERA website for any other information. Thank you very much for watching. See you again next month.